We found the radius to be 28.2 centimeters. Once we converted it, that gave us 0.282 meters. Based on our procedure, we found that there were 34 rotations in 60 seconds. So we made a proportion and we found that the period equals 0.567 seconds. To find the frequency, we knew that the formula was 1 over t. In the previous step, we found that t was 0.567. So 1 divided by 0.567 gave us 1.764 hertz. To find angular velocity, the formula was omega equals 2 pi frequency. So we plugged in the numbers and we found that the angular velocity is 11.084 radians per second. Earlier in the video, we found that the radius was 0.282 meters, so we'll be using that number to find the linear velocity. The formula for linear velocity is omega times radius, or angular velocity times radius. So we plugged in those numbers and we found that the velocity is 3.126 meters per second. To find centripetal acceleration, we use the formula velocity squared divided by radius. So after we plugged in those numbers, we found that the centripetal acceleration equals 34.65 meters per second squared. To find centripetal force, we use the formula mass times velocity squared divided by radius. So we found the mass of the pig to be 0.1596 kilograms. And after we plugged in the rest of the numbers, we found that the centripetal force is 5.53 newtons. Finally, we found the angle that the pig made with the ceiling. So we found that the length of the string that the pig was hanging from is 0.306 meters, and we put that over here. And then we also know that the radius is 0.282 meters, so that went here in our diagram, and we're solving for theta. So tangent of theta equals 0.282 divided by 0.306. And we found that theta equals 42.663 degrees.